FM News. On point.
Look at the news, Emily Komjisha. Four people have been shot dead by an army officer and three others were seriously injured in areas of Nansana municipality. The incident happened at Ganda Chevando, Nansana municipality in Wakiso district, where four lost their lives and three were injured in the incident. According to available information, Dennis Omara Kopolo, an LDU commander attached to Ganda Detach, who's suspected to have been under the influence of alcohol, shot dead four people, including Special Police Constable Isaac Nimulunji, LDU's number AX301784, Abraham Masireka. Others were shot are AXL017516, John Wafula, and a civilian woman, Rita Nabayingo, a resident of Nsubi Village, Chevando Parish, Wakiso District. Dennis Williamar was later put out of action. Police Constable David Ochen was also injured. Two other civilians yet to be identified were injured and rushed to a known clinic, according to Kampala Metropolitan Police PRO Patrick Onyango.
Bodies were taken to Mulago City mortuary for post-mortem. The suspect fired 18 bullets. Motive of the shooting is still unknown. Investigation into the incident is ongoing.
The High Court has set January 14, 2021 to decide the fate of journalists who are not accredited by the Media Council on whether they can cover the election process. The date, which falls on the actual voting day for the President and Members of Parliament, has been given by trial judge Esther Nambayo this morning as the case came up for hearing. Journalists under the Editors Guild Uganda and the Centre for Public Interest Law petitioned the court challenging the Media Council's directive, saying this will open a floodgate of brutality against them by security personnel during enforcement. They say the Media Council is only responsible for licensing editors, while the mandate to accredit journalists is for the National Institute for Journalists in Uganda. They further argue that it is the role of the media to disseminate information to the public, and that any lawful conditions such as accreditation by the Media Council interferes with their functions. They also want court to stop journalists' accreditation and state functions, saying it is not their mandate. Now, the government is to set up a mobile unit to move around different organizations and companies to see if their workers have been allowed to go and vote. The deputy RSCC Nakam municipality, Anderson Burora, says they have received information that some of their companies are refusing their employees from participating in the election, yet every Ugandan who's 18 years and above has a right to choose a leader. Burora now wants companies and organizations to allow their employees to either work in shifts or work half day so that their rights are also respected. Burora says the mobile unit that is going to be established will be mandated with moving around companies to ensure employers allow their employees vote.
We have instituted the mobile committee of security that will be moving from companies and organizations to check whether workers have been able to vote.
Burora urged Ugandans to maintain peace and also remain vigilant, as elections will not stop criminals from committing crimes.
The public is also hereby requested to protect their peace, protect their security, and to ensure that no one violates the rights of others.
In other news, Pope Francis said he's not sure if his trip to Iraq in March can take place because of the COVID-19 pandemic. He cast doubt on the trip, which would be the first by a pope to the country, in an interview with Italy's Canal 5 broadcast. Francis spoke in a section of the interview about how his life had changed because of the pandemic, and now he had to cancel trips that had been planned for the last year. The March 5th to 8th trip is due to take the Pope to the capital, Baghdad, as well as your city linked to the Old Testament figure of Abraham, and Erbil, Mosul, and Karakosh in the plain of Nineveh. Iraqi President Bahram Saleh said in a post on Twitter when the trip was announced last month that the trip will be a message of peace to Iraqis of all regions and religions, and also serve to affirm common values of justice and dignity. The 84-year-old Pope is expected to get vaccinated against COVID-19 this week. He said in the interview, everyone who is able should get vaccinated. And that was the news.
XFM News. On Point.